What is it like working with Tom Hanks? I mean, he's a legend. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He wrote the screenplay. You know, he's the star of Greyhound. Yeah. You're working with him. What's it like?
Well, wouldn't that be everyone's dream, you know, to do a film with someone like that? And I was very much looking forward to it. And when, you know, when you're a DP on a movie like that and you've got an iconic actor or iconic director or someone who you're working with, it's like I think about, man, I really have to make sure I bring my A game. Not that I never don't, but it's like you think about it. I cannot be lazy for 1 second. I cannot, you know, I've got to stay with this movie and I've got to, you know, totally go, completely go all in with it. In the case of Tom, it was very funny because he never left the set. He walked on that set day one and walked off the last day, and he wasn't the type that would go run off to his trailer at all. In fact, the very first day, the first setup, he came up and said, Hey, Shelley, does your grip have one of those Apple boxes with a little pad on it? I said, yeah, sure. He said, well, do you think you could bring that up for me? Because I'll just sit here in the corner. I said, yeah, sure. So I went to the key grip, Bob Babb, and I said, hey, Bob, you want to make a friend for life, go bring Tom one of those Apple boxes with a pad on it for him.
Wow.
And so he did. And that Apple box didn't leave that set for a month. I mean, I think it's a few shots with it in there. Because whenever we called cut, new setup, Tom would just go to the corner. He would just lean back on the set and close his eyes. And we'd be working with, he has his own stand-in that would help us. And so we'd be working with the stand-in, and the stand-in would whisper to me, don't think for a minute that he's sleeping. He's listening. He said, oh, I know. I know.
That's awesome.
And so we'd be working, he'd be at the squawk box, and I would be working with the stand-in, John, and I would ask John, I said, oh, if we have Tom just look down, we'll get that eye. We'll get that interactive light in his eyes. Do you think he would do that for us? And then you hear Tom from the corner, what do you want me to do?
Oh my God.
And he'd walk over and I said, well, Tom, here's a situation. It's like, if you look down for this, we'll get that glint in the eye for this moment. Yeah. Sure. Yeah. And he'd go back and sit down.
Wow.
He was wonderful. He gave us everything we could possibly want. He's extremely generous and understands exactly, you know, what the camera needs and kind of what the camera crew needs. And is very patient with us. Interestingly, he plays a song at the beginning of every day. He goes to the sound department and he brings a song to play over the loudspeakers.
Really?
Every day, every morning, there's a different song. And so all our songs were like Navy-themed songs, pop songs or folk songs or whatever they were. But they all had some kind of Navy or ship theme.
Just to kind of like pump up the crew for the day?
Just to get everyone ready for the day. Yep.
Here no we are. Way.
We're on the clock and here's the song. Here's the day's song. And every day, so he brought in 35 songs. You know, a different song that he personally did and gave to the people.
Wow.
Yeah. And it got to the point where our console operators were even doing little light shows to them. They could improvise because we had sky panels up there, which could do anything. So they could, you know, do all kinds of interesting light shows during our song.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So he's all about creating a camaraderie and creating energy. You know, on top of it, he wrote the script, he's producing it, his company was producing it.
Sure.
You know, he's in it and he wants that spirit of that creative spirit to be a big part of the filmmaking experience, you know. And so he sets the tone. He leaves after 12 hours, you better plan your day accordingly, because he does insist on having his time off and so you do.
Yeah.
Take that very seriously and take care of him and treat him like a movie star and he's very, very good. And what's interesting is when you watch him, and I did a film like with Tommy Lee Jones, he was kind of a similar where you're watching them on the set and you're watching them perform and you swear they're not doing enough. There's performances are so subtle that you're almost missing it to the naked eye of the camera scene. He's so good. Those guys are so good at just putting the performance where the lens is.
Yeah.
And the subtlety and the layers are there. And then you see him in the movie and it's like, oh my God, you know, how did he do this? It's just amazing. You know, he's
that's interesting.
Smart.
Like you are wanting and expecting more when you're behind the camera because you're active, you're like in the scene, but when you're watching it, It doesn't need to be that big.
And who am I to judge? This is more of an observation from me, because I'm not, that's not even my table at all. But it's something I see with really good actors is that subtlety. You know, there's that point where you almost lose the naked eye, but the lens sees it.
Yeah.
And they work on that fine line, which is, you know, very, very fun to watch. You know, when you're talking about people who are masters of what they do. And so that's beautiful to see someone who's that good work that way. You know?
I love that.